Hi guys, how are you doing? It's Elaine Bintz, health coach, personal trainer. Thank you everybody who came to the Dyer anytime last night. It was great meeting new people. Please keep doing awesome in your 30-day challenge. Please keep asking me questions. It's great. You guys, the pictures are wonderful. You've given me a lot of great ideas for my grocery list. So some of the questions I've gotten recently about nutrition are how to raise healthy eaters. So although I don't have a ton of experience with this, our son is only 17 months old and I did breastfeed for the first year. I have learned a couple of things along the ways from my clients and my nieces and nephews and then our son. So the main takeaway is that your kids will eat whatever you eat. So if your eating habits are healthier, usually your children's eating habits are healthier. So it's kind of the trickle-down effect. So some of the things we've tried with our son that he really likes are homemade lentils. These are just some lentils I made the other day. I seasoned them with taco seasoning, and my husband and I, we ate lentil tacos, and you can make lentil nachos. You can throw these on a salad. He really likes the seasoning. So I found that if there's a fruit or a vegetable or something he may not want to eat plain, like the fruit, if I add a little bit of cinnamon, he'll eat it, or nutmeg, or the vegetable, if I throw a little bit of Italian seasoning or a little bit of Italian dressing, he'll eat it. Of course, we have to portion things out. He eats in what would be the equivalent of about a 1 cup amount of food. I'll give him about 1 cup at a time. Since he is so young and he only has 10 teeth right now. He has 8 in the front and then he has 2 molars up on top. So at this stage of the game, we are just trying to expose him to as many foods as possible. I will definitely say one awesome thing about my son. He has really forced me to eat more fruit. I don't know if it's been my experience in the fitness world, being a competitor and counting calories and things like that, but there was a time period where I didn't eat any fruit, and fruit is really healthy, and I should be eating more of it. So some of his favorites I pack for daycare are things like these pre-portioned applesauces, really easy on the go, are bananas. He really loves all fruit. Berries, he likes strawberries, blueberries. I'll throw some in yogurt for him. He loves that combo. So for your kids, say they're a little bit older and maybe you haven't been feeding them the healthiest diet since they were an infant like our son. You can start at any time. You can always expose your kids to new things. If you're at a restaurant, maybe try getting a healthier side versus fries, or try asking them to try something that's healthier before they try something that's fried or not as healthy. So at the end of the day, you're the parent, you make the rules, and you're doing the grocery shopping and you're putting the food on the plate. So I would always charge my clients and my moms and dads to say, hey, how do you want to feed them? You know, what do you want them to put in their bodies? This became very apparent to me when I became a mother and I wanted to really focus on nourishing myself well because I was nursing. I knew whatever I was eating, eventually my son was eating. And then of course, when he started eating more salads and foods like at the dinner time that we were eating, it made me reflect and think even more about what I was cooking because he's eating those exact foods. So from personal experience, I can say it's not always easy. Also working full time, it is difficult to put together a healthy meal every night, but that's where a lot of your frozen products come in. Aldi, Meijer, Strack and Van Til, your Walt's, a lot of grocery stores have really healthy, already frozen prepared meals that you can reheat in the microwave, maybe add a little bit of seasoning or a little bit of dressing, and dinner is done. So of course, I don't have all the answers. Like I said, I've only been a parent a short amount of time, but usually if you're eating a healthy diet, you're gonna be raising children who are eating a healthier diet. And always try new things. If your child's never had cantaloupe or kiwi, you know, try it, buy it, and have them try a few bites. And if they don't like it this year, that doesn't mean they're not going to like it in the future. Our taste buds change and evolve as we get older. You know, as children, their taste buds are very vibrant. They taste everything they eat. But as we age, you know, if we have habits like cigarette smoking or drinking alcohol, or say, you know, we drink a lot of coffee, we actually kill our taste buds. So as adults, we need more sugar and salt in order to have the food taste more palatable. palatable. Whereas children, their taste buds, they taste everything that goes in their mouth. So please fill me in on any tips and any ideas you have. Like I said, I know right now my son loves spinach, broccoli. He loves a lot of greens. But I know that what my friends tell me is that's not going to last forever. So thank you guys again. I love your questions. I love your pictures. Keep doing awesome with this 30-day challenge. And I'll see you soon. Thanks, guys. Bye.